So let us continue with the first video. So just we have seen the LHS side of the power factor meter. Now let us see the RHS side of the power factor meter. So A, B, C, these three terminals are connected sequentially to R, Y, B. In any one phase, we can put the ammeter in series with this connection. So this is the one ammeter connected. So let us see the connection on the actual meter. So you can see here, this is A terminal, B terminal and C terminal. A, B, C are connected to R, Y and B. A, B, C terminals are connected to R, Y and B. So this is the connection for armature winding. Now let us see the field winding connection. So this is our field. This is connected to DC source. So this is the DC source available here. Across this we have made potential divider circuit. So this is the rheostat for potential divider circuit. Variable point is connected to ammeter, DC ammeter, and the other end of DC ammeter is connected to field winding, and second end of the field winding is connected back to the negative. So this is the connection for field winding. So let us see on the actual machine. So this is the source available, plus and minus terminal. So plus and minus, you can see these two wires, blue color wires, are connected to fixed terminals. This is the plus and this one is the minus. So these are the two fixed terminals connected across, plus and minus. You can see here, this is the variable point of the rheostat. It is connected to DC ammeter. So this is the DC ammeter. Other end of the DC ammeter, you can see, other end is connected to plus terminal of the field winding. So this is the field winding plus terminal, or you can say F. Other end of the field winding, that is minus, is connected back to the negative terminal of the source. So this double F or negative is connected back to negative terminal. So this is all about the connection diagram. Thank you very much.